Meghan Markle and Prince Harry are at the center controversy over their use of luxury private jets, but, as royal watchers condemn or defend the couple, a newly resurfaced report reveals that Kate Middleton refused an opportunity to upgrade her airline ticket to first class when she flew to the Caribbean in 2008. Last week, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex took four journeys on a private jet within 11 days. They first traveled to Ibiza to celebrate Meghan's 38th birthday and then flew to Nice and stayed at Sir Elton John's house. The move sparked huge criticism, as the royal duo has often spoken out about climate change and the need to protect the environment. In July, a post on their Instagram page read, "With nearly 7.7 billion people inhabiting this earth, every choice, every footprint, every action makes a difference." Sir Elton defended their use of jets, writing on Twitter that he is deeply distressed by the criticism and paid to carbon offset their journey to France. As royal watchers continue to either defend or hit out at the couple, a newly resurfaced report reveals down-to-earth Kate Middleton refused an opportunity to upgrade her airline ticket to first class when she flew to the Caribbean. According to a 2008 report by the Daily Telegraph, the now Duchess of Cambridge was traveling to the island of Mustaki in the Grenadines for a holiday with Prince William. When asked by British Airways cabin crew if she would have liked to travel first class for free, Kate refused and reportedly insisted on being treated like a normal passenger. She told the crew, "Please call me Kate." A British Airways source told the publication at the time, "She may be dating the future king, but she's so down to earth. It's the first time we have had a passenger turn down the chance of an upgrade." Even after marrying into the royal family, the Duchess does not seem to have changed her mentality and keeps flying commercial wherever she can. In 2013, she traveled with her six-month-old baby, Prince George, on a British Airways flight to St. Lucia. In 2016, she flew again with British Airways from London to Rotterdam for her first solo trip. Bodyguards reportedly escorted her on the plane for the 50-minute flight, where she sat in the front row. People on the plane immediately grabbed their phones and snapped pictures of her. The only perk she received was to be escorted off the plane first, once it landed, a couple of minutes before the other passengers. Earlier today, poll urged the Duke and Duchess of Sussex to stop preaching about being environmentally conscious. The Queen and the immediate heirs to the throne are the only members of the royal family who should be allowed to use private jets for their trips, the majority of voters in a survey carried out by express.co.uk said. The poll, taken between August 19 and 20 by 4,262 people, saw 1,488 voters agreeing that only the Queen, Prince Charles, and Prince William should be allowed to travel with private aircraft. However, the question asked, "Should Meghan Markle, Prince Harry, and other royals use private jets for travel?" split voters, with as many as 1,201 believing no member of the royal family should travel with private jets. Some 854 people believe only the Queen and Prince Philip should fly using private jets, while as many as 569 people believe all the working members of the royal family must have access to private aircraft. Meghan and Harry have been urging the public to take steps to tackle climate change and become more environmentally conscious. Prince Harry is believed to have traveled, with a private jet, to Sicily at the end of July to attend a yearly Google Camp, a gathering attended by A-listers to discuss several topics, including climate change and politics. There, the Duke of Sussex is said to have delivered a speech barefoot focused on the environment. Amid the ongoing fallout, Prince William is said to be increasingly concerned about his younger brother. Appearing on Channel 5 documentary William and Harry, Princes at War, royal expert Ingrid Seward said, "I would think it might bother William a little bit, because he might see the way that Harry and Meghan do things as being detrimental to the business of the monarchy as a whole." Speaking about Harry and Meghan's snubbing protocol, Ms. Seward said, "It wasn't done in a very royal way, or the way we'd come to expect. But then Harry's excuse was, well, I'm a private person. But you cannot be royal and be sixth in line to the throne and be a private person. This sort of behavior has led to Ms. Seward suggesting Prince William might be bothered by the way his younger brother acts, potentially harming the monarchy.